Queen Elizabeth II and Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, attended Sunday service together this morning, as the Cambridges continue to enjoy some time off at Balmoral with the monarch and Prince Philip. The Queen was joined by Kate today as the pair headed to Crathy Kirk, the church near Balmoral Castle usually attended by the monarch during her Scottish summer retreat. The Queen and Kate were chaperoned by Prince William, who sat in the front seat of the Royal Bentley. The monarch sported a bright pink ensemble with pale blue details, and accessorized her outfit with her signature pearl earrings and necklace. Kate donned a £225 midi green peacock patterned shirt dress by designer Michael Kors, paired with a fascinator and a navy coat with gold buttons. The ever-stylish Duchess accessorized her outfit with a pair of gold hoop earrings, and wore her hair in a loose bun hidden under a hat. Prince William looked dapper in a grey suit, a white buttoned-up shirt and a red tie. The trio seemed in very good spirit and were all smiles as they were driven to one of the Queen's favorite church in Aberdeenshire. In one picture, the Queen, Kate, and Prince William can be seen laughing, while in other snaps the Duchess of Cambridge and the Queen are spotted chatting to each other. The royals were welcomed to Crathy Kirk by hundreds of adoring well-wishers who waited for them under the sun. Delighted to see so many royal fans, William, Kate, and the Queen happily waved at them before entering the church. The monarch and the Cambridges weren't the only royals attending Sunday service today. Prince Charles and Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, were the first to arrive at church. The Queen's car was followed by Prince Edward, the monarch's youngest son, his wife Sophie Wessex and their daughter, Lady Louise Windsor. Princess Anne, the Princess Royal, her husband Tim Lawrence, her son Peter Phillips and her daughter-in-law Autumn Phillips were also in attendance. Both the Wessexes and Prince Charles and Camilla have been staying at Balmoral for weeks now. The Cambridges, on the other hand, traveled to Balmoral Castle from their residence in Norwich from August 22. Kate Middleton offered a big smile on the car ride to church alongside Queen Elizabeth II in Scotland on Sunday morning. The Duchess of Cambridge and her husband, Prince William, flew to the UK's northernmost country 3 days prior to be with the family's matriarch. Kate chose a stylish navy double-breast herringbone coat for the outing, which she paired with a small black forward-leaning hat. The Queen, sporting a vibrant pink coat and matching hat, looked equally cheerful, waving at the cameras and onlookers on their way to Crathy Kirk, the parish where they attended church. In the front seat, alongside the driver, was William, who also offered a smile as their car rolled out of Balmoral Castle, where the family is staying. According to a source, Kate and William, as well as Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, are all visiting in Scotland at the Queen's residence to mark the end of summer, however likely not at the same time. Kate and William flew commercial with their three children Prince George, 6, Princess Charlotte, 4, and 1-year-old Prince Louis after Meghan Markle and Prince Harry came under fire for recently taking a private jet to Ibiza, Spain, for the Duchess' 38th birthday, a luxury which some argued runs counter to their environmental activism. After the couple was roundly criticized for the flight, a number of fellow celebs, including Elton John and Ellen DeGeneres, showed their support. "I am deeply distressed by today's distorted and malicious account in the press surrounding the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's private stay at my home in Nice last week," John wrote in a tweet on August 19. "Prince Harry's mother Diana, Princess of Wales, was one of my dearest friends. I feel a profound sense of obligation to protect Harry and his family from the unnecessary press intrusion that contributed to Diana's untimely death." The singer went on to explain that, when Harry and Meghan previously traveled to France, he was the one who provided the royals with a private flight, to ensure privacy and protection. He even made a contribution to carbon footprint in order to render the flight carbon neutral. John concluded by writing, "I highly respect and applaud both Harry and Meghan's commitment to charity, and I'm calling on the press to cease these relentless and untrue assassinations on their character that are spuriously crafted on an almost daily basis." The couple, their children, and their nanny were spotted disembarking the 8.45 AM flight, which cost at the time £73 per person, as Meghan Markle and Prince Harry were involved in a bitter row over their use of private jets. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex were spotted taking a private jet 4 times in 11 days to head first to Spain and then to France. On August 6, the pair took Archie Harrison on his first holidays abroad, as they celebrated Meghan's birthday with a 6-day stay in Ibiza. And shortly after their return to the UK, they left once again on Wednesday last week for a 3-day holiday at Elton John's home in Nice, France. These journeys produced 82 tons of CO2, according to an analysis of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex emissions published by The Times. Kate and William have been initially praised by members of the public and commentators for choosing to fly with a low-cost carrier. But flight records suggest Flybe may have sent an empty aircraft to Norwich just to pick up the Cambridges, according to the Mail Online. Speaking to the news organization, a source said, "It's utterly extraordinary and makes a mockery of their family's very laudable attempts to travel more economically and in a more environmentally friendly manner." An additional 4.5 tons of carbon emissions were created simply to ensure that an aircraft with Flybe written on the side operated the flight with the royal party aboard, instead of the usual aircraft which flies the route. It's obviously not their fault but is utterly ridiculous. However, Flybe has denied this claim. A spokesman for the company said, "Flybe denies any involvement in the decision over which aircraft to fly on this route, which is fully operated by Eastern Airways."